Here on historic Burnside Street in Bristol, Rhode Island, Bristol Boat Company and Herreshoff Designs are teaming up to bring an original Nathaniel Greene Herreshoff design to life, 80 years after Captain Nat first envisioned it. The boat, named the Herreshoff 20, is beginning to take shape under the able hands and careful eye of master boat builder Dan Shea. Under Shea's direction, the Herreshoff 20 makes full usage of time-honored wooden boat building methods and techniques, but also marries in newer and more dramatically advanced materials and methods of wooden boat building, all contributing to a stronger and yet lighter hull than any previous building techniques and materials would have ever allowed.
All right. It's almost a boat. Let's go put in the water. There we go.
Several people were on hand to witness the turning over of hull number one of the Herreshoff 20, conceived here 80 years ago.
Does it look like the picture, Mr. Naval Architect?
Inspired by the Herreshoff 12½, the most popular and best-selling Herreshoff boat ever made, and Captain Nat's personal favorite, the Herreshoff 20 was envisioned as a bigger and more comfortable day sailor. Though the boat was never built, Captain Nat carved a half-hull model in 1929, and it was this model that caught the eye of Halsey Herreshoff and fellow designer Adam Langerman and inspired them to develop the modern plans for the boat's construction, all the while staying true to Captain Nat's original vision. Enter master boat builder Dan Shea, and the Herreshoff 20 dream is finally about to come true.
Despite the liberal use of epoxy and things, it actually looks like a real wooden boat, doesn't it? It was sort of the object, and I'm stuck on this theme of good boats have frames, so you see the frames. It was very important to me that the boat from the inside that you could see looked like a traditionally built boat, including all the framing parts. Then for torsional purposes, we've added two layers of eighth inch Spanish cedar set on diagonals of 90 degrees to each other to keep the boat from twisting. We've included a detail that's very common in joiner work, and that is the use of a spline, which you see here. A spline does two things. First of all, in running the full length of the plank, it aligns the planks edge to edge, and also it gives the joining of the planks with the epoxy glue more surface area. And by that I mean, if you are just butt joining the two planks, you would have 3/10 of an inch of surface area to join. In adding the spline, you have all the surface area around the spline, basically tripling the amount of adhesion you get. It's quite a bit lighter. We're looking at something on the order of 500 pounds, perhaps. And in saying that, if you look at the size of the parts, for instance, the laminated shear clamp, the keelson and stem, and you can see the breadth of the stem forward, they're not slight parts. These are substantial parts. Hello, Halsey.
Well, this is a important day. Doesn't it look nice?
It looks more like a boat.
The interior finish is outstanding. And you've got your cockpit floor.
I've framed the floor.
Well, I just think, in answer to your question, that this has all the right elements to be a very outstanding sailboat, because I know the hull is such that it will sail well, and the workmanship and the way it's built has enabled it to be a very light hull, so it'll have a high ballast ratio and be stiff, and so stiff that I'm thinking we should increase the rig just a little bit from what we first estimated. And I think where we've concentrated on the day sailing feature, this very large cockpit and adequate but minimal interior, that's going to be just, should be a winner as far as the day sailing will. Well, it's a good teamwork. My grandfather will be smiling on this. Adam Langerman, my partner in the designing, working with Dan. Kind of fortunate we're close neighbors here. So, it should work.
I'm fortunate to get to turn the screws. That's my role.
Of course, there are many.
Yeah.